Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today I wanted to share how I do my hair for jujitsu. I started doing classes again and your hair always gets snagged and pulled out while rolling. Some girls will actually shave the bottom part of their hair to keep that from happening. This is my alternative to that. So let me know what you think about this type of tutorial down below in the comment section. Like and subscribe if you're new. Click that notification bell as always. And let's get started. The main goal for this hairstyle is to minimize how much hair is sticking out so it's not grabbed or pulled out. Flip your head upside down and use some water to smooth down the hair at the nape of the neck. You're going to be braiding the hair around the nape into a French braid to mimic an undercut. Pick up a tiny piece of hair at the center of the base of the neck and divide it into three smaller pieces. Begin by crossing the right strand over the middle. Then cross the left strand over the middle. Now begin incorporating small sections of hair into the braid. So you're crossing the side strands over the middle strand while also picking up small sections of hair from both sides of the braid. Cross the left strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over and into the middle strand. Then cross the right strand over the middle, pick up a new piece of hair and cross it over into the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. Start by picking up pieces that are right next to the braid, and then slowly work your way outward. Bringing in hair in this pattern will make kind of a V shape with the braid. And you'll want to keep the pieces really small so the braid is a lot smaller and tighter. I've found that the smaller I keep the braid, the better it stays in through 3 to 4 wrestling rolls. If the hair is brought in larger pieces, it's just easier for one big piece to fall loose and it's really hard to tuck it back in once that happens. So continue crossing the side strands over the middle strand while also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. Cross the left strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over and into the middle strand. Then cross the right strand over the middle. Pick up a new piece of hair and cross it over into the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. Because the braid is so tight and small, it can be difficult when you first start trying to do this hairstyle. I've found the best way to make it work on the first try is to go slowly and really work on keeping the braid clean as you go. Clear away extra little hairs as you're braiding so they don't get tangled up. You can also cross the strands under the middle instead of over to create a Dutch braid version of this style where the braid sits out on top of the hair instead of being tucked under. I find the French braid version easier to keep cleaner as I go. It can be good to switch the two styles so the same hair isn't always rubbing against the mat whenever you're rolling on your back. As soon as you've brought in hair at about the tops of the ears, stop adding in new pieces and just continue braiding the section into a regular 3-strand braid. By continuing to braid the hair elastic is on the ends of the hair instead of stopping here and putting the elastic in the middle of the hair. Once the braid reaches near the ends or the hair is too thin to continue braiding, take a clear elastic band and tie off the end of the braid. You can also backcomb the end of the braid instead if you don't want to have an extra elastic in your hair. Now that your back is killing you from being bent over for 15 minutes, let's do my favorite bun. This is kind of complicated to figure out, but I'll go slow and show you. It's one of my favorites. Combine the rest of the hair together at the top of your head. I'm going to show you how to wrap the hairband before bringing the hair into it. Take your hairband and slide it over your fingers so it sits between your ring and pinky finger and then over your thumb. You're going to be pulling it over the ponytail, twisting it with your left hand and then wrapping it back over the hair again. So now let's add in the hair. So pull the hairband over the hair once without pulling the ponytail all the way through. Grab all of the hair with your left hand and then twist your hand underneath the hair so it flips all the way forwards. Once the hair is flipped to the front of the bun, let it hang down towards the right side so it's not in the way of your left hand. Then wrap the hairband over the hair and this will create 2 loops in the bun. So pull the hairband over the hair once without pulling the ponytail all the way through. Grab all of the hair with your left hand
and then twist your hand underneath the hair so it flips all the way forwards. Once the hair is flipped to the front of the bun, let it hang down towards the right side so it's not in the way of your left hand. Then wrap the hairband over the hair, and this will create two loops in the bun. Now with the ends still sticking out, wrap this around to the back of the bun and tuck them around the hairband so they're wrapped out of the way as well. You can leave out any little ends that might be sticking out, or you can wrap them again around the elastic just so everything's really tucked away. After that, go back over the style with a firm hold hairspray and smooth down any loose hairs that are sticking out just so they can't get pulled or grabbed. You can also use a wax stick to help keep the style really smooth if you prefer. These do work really well. I usually use them on the days right before I'm going to wash my hair.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know what you think about this type of tutorial down below in the comment section. Be sure to like and subscribe if you're new. Click that notification bell as always, and I will see you next time.